We're back here in the cheap seats. We have a question.
I don't know. I don't know if you really, I don't usually respond to people who haven't paid a lot.
Sorry. Hi, Dr. Phillips. My name is Anna. I'm from Gemini, Inc., and I have kind of a, not a lengthy question. I'll try to make it quick, but it's for someone that couldn't be here today. But he says, being that money plays such a huge role in the political process, do you believe that one of the first steps to recovering a more fair and even-handed government begins with evening the playing field via campaign finance reform?
Well, what do you mean by campaign finance reform?
And he says, in essence, capping the amount one can spend on a political campaign as well as the amount that can be poured into one by wealthy donors and corporations.
Would that still permit somebody with deep pockets themselves to contribute to his own campaign?
Probably.
No, that's not good. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So, I don't know. I don't know if campaign finance reform in and of itself is going to make the type of system that we have that much more heedful. I think we need other things besides that as well. Let me put it that way. And you're just asking me as a regular American citizen.
Yeah.
I think we'd still maybe have the same, that we may not still have the same plethora of choices. I don't know. But I think that it certainly is of concern more and more, given what's going on in this recent election and all the super PACs. Even quite conservative elected officials are starting to say maybe we've unleashed a monster here and something needs to be done. But I have to say, I'm not sure if our existing Constitution addresses that. I know a lot of people, given the fact that the Supreme Court is unconstitutionally determining about Citizens United, if it's still allowed to unconstitutionally make that decision, I'm not sure that a lot of things are going to be done, because I'm not sure that it is unconstitutional as things stand now. I think people would actually have to stand up and get a constitutional amendment passed. But people keep looking to everybody else to do these things. And I would simply ask people to start looking in the mirror and ask yourself, what can I do? It's not, and enough of this, well, I'll do it if so-and-so does it too. These movements start with one person here and there. But you have to take a stand whether others do or not. And it's time to get involved and become more and more We the People.
Thank you.